seek your invaluable time. Sit closely and mossy, attend to my rhyme. I have a proposal, suppose it were true, it may cause a kerfuffle and ruffle a few. I have a proposal, suppose it would float, that it's men who depended on us for the vote. Let us say, let us play, that in 1914, with inventions like engines and flying machines, chance for advancement men finally see to be swimming with women in politics stream. Now, ladies, be gracious and let's hear their plea. They appeal that the deal should be equality. So enter then, gentlemen, welcome and not, and batter this matter in Parliament's Hall. I'm impressed that you've dressed in suits so fine, a smatter of chatter will leer on this line. And your wives, I surmise, don't mind that you're here. They must suffer your suffrage like roughage with cheer. I doubt that your clout would be questioned. However, I'm sure you'll concur they're generally not, and the votes would be mostly just wasted or bought. This folly of politics only corrupts your wives' good lives, it enough interrupts. No, you fellas so zealous, good-looking and smart, should resign your designs to the realms of the heart. It's only a fallacy, ballots mean much, as the yard and the car need a gentleman's touch. Keep in mind why you struggle and shovel in snow. We just govern by shoveling that other, you know. And men go ballistic, statistics have shown they're too proud when allowed to vote on their own. They lurch out of church, end up in the jails, unsettled, unfettered, and riding the rails. Now need I say more? I adore my own father. Why wish him more hurry, more worry and bother? Worth. Otherwise, she devised that men also give birth.